busy North London street today at lunchtime. A spot of Christmas shopping and a bite to eat. But just around the corner, they're taking carrier bags into the local food bank. People, we were told, come in not having eaten for days.
There are people queuing up out there for food on a Sunday. They've come, and some of them may have come from many distances. So if we have our last half year figures, 500,000, of which a high proportion of those are children, and the last full year, 1 million people. And I'm a volunteer in 2 food banks. I see people across the spectrum coming in daily who are asking for food. That this is not stopping. This is not stopping. Our numbers continue to rise.
Tomorrow, a report by a group of MPs will call for more government help. And it's been backed by the Archbishop of Canterbury, who writes in a paper today that he was more shocked by the plight of those at food banks here than of those he'd seen in a refugee camp in the Congo. There, he says, it was somehow expected, but it was not to be expected here.
This further opens up the divide between the government and the church, with some MPs questioning whether families really do need these food banks. And the Church of England today saying that what they actually need mostly is urgent help to tackle hunger.
Our understanding is that tomorrow's report will recommend an end to food waste, 4.3 million tonnes a year, ending rip-off Britain, in which poorer people are charged more for credit, utilities and phones, the introduction of a living wage, and a yellow card system so benefits aren't suddenly stopped when they miss an appointment for reasons beyond their control. There isn't a call for more welfare in the report that wouldn't sit easily alongside George Osborne's plans for £12 billion cuts. But, and this isn't likely to be welcomed either, they want a new public body with 8 ministers, charities and food banks overseeing free food distribution. However, there was support for super food banks to deal with the hunger and its causes in the same place.
It's great that there are so many volunteers giving up their spare time to serve the communities around them. But this is a symptom. This isn't solving the cause. And the causes, debt, addiction, worklessness, family breakdown, need to be tackled in order to try and tackle food poverty at its core.
And we've got other sorts of pulses as well.
In this chilly Haringey Church Hall in North London this afternoon, they were filling bags for a man currently out of work. The basics, canned potatoes, tomatoes, rice and pasta. It was his last visit. They're only allowed 3 in a year. It's to prevent dependency, to help in a crisis. But it has to be said, as he left, the volunteers looked worried about what he would do next.